anybody who listens to Conspiracy Land will understand why.
Right. And, you know, they make the point, they make the same point, actually, that we make in the podcast, which is that in social media, it is so easy for these wacko theories and claims from really fringe groups to circulate.
There's Chloe. Are you? You see?
Yes.
I would like to smoke when we get home. Order in, and then do what we're supposed to do on Wednesday.
Okay, you want a drink? I'll hold your paw.
Director, but a guy who's been getting some attention for some critical things he's been saying about the president of the late, and which we want to discuss with him. Anthony, welcome back to school. It's
really
great. Sabrina, drink. You got a kiss?
You think Mitch McConnell is not telling the truth?
No.
Well, I don't know. Where's Mitch McConnell saying that the tweets are racist?
I know. You can do it on Twitter.
Yes. And the president's not racist. I can prove to you empirically
that he's not
racist.
That's fine, too.
But those tweets are racist. And so, no, don't do that, because why do that? You're going to win. Why win?
They do that way. Right.
In the meantime, you got to judge people by their actions, not by their words. Look at what he's done for prison reform. Look at what he's doing to end recidivism. Look at what he's doing to improve the economic situation for the African American unemployment, Hispanic American unemployment, etc. So, but don't say stuff like that.
Slap up and kiss down. If they're kissing up and
clapping down, then we have a nightmare on our hands. So I have people inside here that will open the door and tell me what they think I'm doing right and wrong. Frankly, a lot of the times they're right when I'm doing something wrong, and that helps improve my business. And so if the president is now surrounded by people that are not going to tell him the truth, and they're going to confirm his biases, which may not be correct,